Hello and welcome back to another video with It's Dr. Dan, and today we're going to be learning about the diatomic elements and exactly what are they and how they bond together. So the diatomic elements, these are naturally occurring gases that exist in our everyday world, and what these are different elements that have the tendency to want to bond to themselves. So whenever we have these created during chemical reactions, or if we're trying to actually just write these as they naturally are, they are commonly found to be bound to themselves, meaning that for every one molecule, you're going to have two individual atoms. So what are they? So the seven here, I like to call them by a bunch of different names. I like to call them the diatomic seven, where you have hydrogen, nitrogen, fluorine, oxygen, iodine, chlorine, and bromine. And all these different gases, like I said, they bond to themselves. So remembering these is vital to a general chemistry student because they are used so often, especially when you're learning about chemical reactions and gas laws. So how exactly do you remember these? There's so many of them. It can be very, very difficult to try to commit any of this stuff to memory because there's so much to remember. So with everything, I love having mnemonics to try to remember every little piece of information that we have. So for this, the phrase that you have to remember is have no fear of ice cold beer, which is always true no matter what. If you're in or outside, if you're outside the class, that is always going to be a true statement. So having no fear. All right. So every first letter here is one of your diatomics. So have is hydrogen. No is nitrogen. F for fluorine from fear. Of is oxygen. I is iodine. And C, chlorine. And B is bromine. So if you remember, have no fear of ice cold beer, you will never forget your seven diatomics. Write it down. It's something that's going to help you remember these for your chemistry course. So we're going to go next is to show why does this happen? Why do they exist in this natural state? Why are these gases so different? Why are they bond to themselves and exist in this different way? So we're going to take a look at this. So the diatomic gases, they bond to themselves. And one of the things we like to try to demonstrate for chemistry students is that they love to bond to themselves. So what exactly, how are they presented? So many of these gases, they are referred to as, when we're talking about the diatomic version, is we like to say like hydrogen gas, oxygen gas, fluorine gas, chlorine gas, and that's referring to the molecular form. So the word gas is extremely important. So for example, if I have hydrogen gas, which is the first one, you would see it written as H2, and generally in parentheses afterwards, it is demonstrating a gas, so that way you know what you are working with. Now let's talk about how is this bonded. Well, it all has to do with the valence electrons of all these different elements, and knowing how we can count and try to understand how many do they have. So the first one, hydrogen, right? So if you think from your periodic table, it is in column number one, so it has a single valence electron, meaning that if I were to try to bring it near another hydrogen, well, if they were to bond together, we can see, hey, it ends up fulfilling the orbital for each one of these hydrogens. Remember, hydrogen likes to fulfill the duet rule, meaning it only needs two electrons in order for it to be fully happy. So the hydrogen on the left has two electrons, and then the hydrogen on the right has two electrons. So we have an even covalent sharing between these two, okay? So, and that's what's most important, right? It's fulfilling its outermost layer. That is the ultimate goal. So now there are elements. So if I want to start with the first one, right, which is fluorine, well, we can think, all right, how many valence electrons does any of the halogens have? Well, all of them have seven valence electrons around them. And that's some from counting the columns of the periodic table, you can get that number. So if we were to draw all those little dots around fluorine, around both of them, we'll line up the single dot next to its other species. And one thing we're going to see is, hey, if this forms a single bond between them, it's sharing two electrons between both of them, meaning that we have a total of eight on one side, the other. So that's one of the most important things as we're seeing.
is we have that equal sharing from both sides. And they both have 8 valence electrons now, and it's so satisfying the octet. And we can do this for any of these species, right? So if I pick another one, let's say if I do chlorine, for example, and we wanted to show this one, this would be the exact same thing because it also has 7 valence electrons. We can show a single bond around it to help illustrate that this has its complete octet just like so. All right, so all of the halogens, they make one single bond and they are able to satisfy their octet covalently, which is the goal. So this is why they exist as diatomics. It's really easy for them. They can bond with their counterpart, and if it fills their octet, it's stable, right? So in order for these to happen, it helps stabilize the structure, and that's really important to realize. Let's go on to the other ones, which are a little harder. So the last two, which is oxygen and nitrogen, are a little bit different. Well, oxygen, how many valence electrons does oxygen have? And you can think about it for a second, and you'll realize, oh, it has 6 valence electrons around it. So we're going to draw 6 dots around this structure. And what we're going to see here is like, okay, well, if I draw these 6 dots, well, how many bonds does it need to form here? Well, if I do the first one and do a single bond, we're going to see, wait a minute, it doesn't quite have enough. If I'm to count all the dots for one of these oxygens, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we don't have 8 at the moment. So what do we need to do? We need to make a complete another bond. So we'll move through these dots, make a double bond. And there we go. We have now a happy octet, which is showing, okay, the one on the right now has 8 valence electrons all being shared with it. And the same thing on the left. They both have a happy octet. So we have a double bond. And this is oxygen gas, just like you're breathing in right now, just like I'm breathing in too. So O2 gas, right? As you can kind of think of, what do you breathe is O2. And it is something that is a vital part of our atmosphere. Same thing with nitrogen, right? We live in a nitrogen-based environment. So once again, we're going to write our Lewis structure. So we have 5 valence electrons for nitrogen. We're going to write them all around. And if you can kind of notice, well, how many vacant dots do I have around nitrogen? Well, you have 3 lonely dots. So if oxygen made a double bond, maybe this can get your brain thinking of what kind of bond I need to make here. So notice how if I make one bond, right, we have a total of only 6 electrons on the right-hand side. So what we need to do is we need to share 2 more to make a total of, make a triple bond, okay? So let's move all of our dots to make a very, very happy structure. And then this would be our first bond, our second bond, and our third bond. And as a result, if you kind of think about and we count all these, so we can count and we can see that, okay, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. All of our valence electrons are taken care of. We have all of them here. So we have a complete valence level. And so this is showing a perfect structure using a triple bond. And this is one of the reasons why nitrogen is so stable within our atmosphere. It's typically something that does not readily react, and that's because it's very difficult to break a triple bond. It's one of the strongest bonds you can have, so it's very strong. And that is how nitrogen naturally exists. So these have been the 7 diatomics, as I mentioned before. Just always kind of keep remembering is have no fear of ice cold beer. And you'll be able to remember all of your diatomics moving forward in your chemistry course. So this has been Dr. Dan. Thank you so much for listening. And just remember, have no fear of ice cold beer. I'll see you all later. Bye now.